Welcome to video lecture on Internet of Things and Technology. In this session, I'll discuss about IoT access technology and in detail about IEEE 802.15.4 access technology used for IoT application deployment. In the previous session, we have learnt about communication criteria for evaluating various access technologies supporting for the deployment of IoT smart object. Various technologies are available for connecting sensor or smart object, but we will look at the technologies that are the most promising going forward based on the current market trends, industry support and market share. For each of the access technology, we will discuss about the common set of information including standardization and alliance. In standardization and alliance, we discuss about the standard bodies that maintain the protocols for access technology. Then we discuss about physical layer for the access technology. It may be wired or wireless method, and we will discuss about the relevant frequencies supported by the access technology. Then we look into MAC layer of the access technology. Then we will study about the topology supported by the access technology. Then we look into the security aspect of the access technology. Then we look into the competitive technologies that are similar and most suitable alternative for the selected access technology. So we are going to learn about set of IoT access technologies and their standardization and alliance, physical layer, MAC layer, topology, security and competitive technologies for each access technologies. So we are going to discuss about the following access technology: IEEE 802.15.4, IEEE 802.15.4G and IEEE 802.15.4E, IEEE 1901.2A, IEEE 802.11AH, LORAWAN, NB-IoT and LTE variation. These are the commonly used IoT access technologies in the current market. We also should remember that there are many more IoT technologies in the market today than the above access technology we are going to discuss. Basic knowledge and awareness about the IoT access technologies are required, as they are the fundamentals for the connecting IoT smart objects. And based on the about IoT access technology, new access technologies are built on. Now we'll see in detail about IEEE 802.15.4 access technology. IEEE 802.15.4 is a wireless access technology. It supports low cost and low data rate devices that are battery operated. They offer a reasonable battery life, which enables this access technologies easy to install using a compact protocol stack. Commonly found applications of IEEE 802.15.4 usage applications are home and building automation, automotive networks, industrial wireless sensor networks, interactive toys and remote controls. Use case of IEEE 802.15.4 range from consumer to business market. These are only the few commonly used criteria or use cases of IEEE 802.15.4 access technology. Now let us look into standardization and alliance of IEEE 802.15.4 802.4, IEEE 802.15.4 is governed by a standard body called IEEE 802.15 Task Group 4. This IEEE 802.15 Task Group 4 defines low data rate PHY and MAC layer specification for wireless personal area networks. This standard has evolved over the years and is well-known solution for low complexity wireless devices with low data rate and that need many months and even a large number of years of battery life. That is, it supports low data rate as well as long battery life of years, that is many years. Many versions of IEEE 802.15.4 are published or established, which will add new feature to the existing IEEE 802.15.4 protocol. There is no standard alliance or promotion body for IEEE 802.15.4. The IEEE 802.15.4 PHY and MAC layers are the foundation for several networking protocol stacks. These protocol stacks make use of IEEE 802.15.4 at the physical and link layer levels, but the upper layers are different. Now let us see few protocol stacks which utilizes IEEE 802.15.4 at physical and link layer level, but the upper layers are different. So first one is ZigBee, second one is 6LoWPAN, next one is wireless HART, next one is Thread, next one is ZigBee IP, and next last one is ISA 100.11A. ZigBee is promoted through the ZigBee Alliance. ZigBee defines upper layer component as well as application profiles. The common profile include building automation, home automation, and healthcare. ZigBee also defines device object functions such as device role, device discovery, network join, and security. We will learn in detail about ZigBee in this particular session. Next one is 6LoWPAN. This is a IPv6 adaptation layer defined by the IETF 6LoWPAN working group that describes how a transport IPv6 packet over IEEE 802.15.4 layers. That is, above the physical and link layer of IEEE 802.15.4, the IETF 6LoWPAN working group has added a IPv6 packet. Next is ZigBee IP. ZigBee IP is an evolution of ZigBee protocol stack. ZigBee IP adopts the 6LoWPAN adaptation layer, that is IPv6 network layer, and RPL routing protocol, that is ZigBee, which implements 6LoWPAN, is called ZigBee IP. Next protocol stack which utilizes IEEE 802.15.4 is ISA 100.11A. ISA 100.11A is developed by the International Society of Automation as wireless system for industrial automation, process control, and related application. So this is mainly used for wireless system for industrial automation process control and related application. It is based on IEEE 802.15.4 2006 version or iteration. The network and transport layers are based on IETF 6 LOWPAN, IPv6 and UDP standards. Wireless HART is also a protocol stack that utilizes IEEE 802.15.4. Wireless HART is promoted by the HART Communication Foundation. It is a protocol stack that offers a time-synchronized self-organizing and self-healing mesh architecture, which is built upon IEEE 802.15.4 2006 version, and the supported frequency band is 2.4 GHz. Thread is also a protocol stack which utilizes IEEE 802.15.4, which is constructed on the top of IETF 6 LOWPAN / IPv6. Thread is a protocol stack for a secure and reliable mesh network to connect and control products in the home. That is, they are mainly used in the home automation system. The specifications are defined and published by the thread group at the www.threadgroup.org. Now let us learn in detail about ZigBee that utilizes protocol stack of IEEE 802.15. ZigBee Alliance is an industry group that certifies interoperability between vendors, and it is committed to driving and evolving of ZigBee as a IoT solution for interconnecting smart objects. So ZigBee Alliance is an industry group that will help the IoT solution for interconnecting smart object using ZigBee. ZigBee solutions are mainly used at smart objects and sensor that have low bandwidth and low power ends. The ZigBee compliant and certified ZigBee Alliance should interoperate even through different vendors, which are manufactured by different vendors. There are several revisions of ZigBee specification. The main use cases of ZigBee are home automation or home application and smart energy, automation for commercial and retail. In industrial and commercial automation space, ZigBee-based device, that is, the smart object which are connected using ZigBee, can handle various functions like measuring temperature, humidity, to tracking assets. That is, they can be used in temperature measurement, humidity sensors, or sensor that track the asset can be connected using ZigBee protocol. In home automation, if we use ZigBee as an access technology, then it control lighting, thermostats and security functions. That is, it connect the sensor that can handle light control, thermostat and security function. ZigBee Smart Energy brings together a variety of interoperable products such as smart meters that can monitor and control the use and delivery of utilities such as electricity and water. That is, in ZigBee Smart Energy, we are using ZigBee as a protocol for connecting some of the sensor which is used to measure smart meter, which can monitor and control the electricity and water. ZigBee products are controlled by the utility provider and can help coordinate usage between homes and business, the utility provider itself, to provide more efficient operation. in the diagram you can see the protocol stack of ZigBee, that is high level ZigBee protocol stack is represented in the presentation. You can see application and profiles, application support, network and security layer, MAC layer and PHY layer. Here you can see MAC and PHY layers are layers present in IEEE 802.15.4, upon which you can find three additional stack which is owned by ZigBee, that is ZigBee platform stack and ZigBee or vendor specific stack. Now we'll learn in detail about the ZigBee stacks, that is network and security layer, application support and application and bar profile, that is ZigBee specifies the network and security layer and application support layer that sit on the top of the lower layers, MAC layer and PHY layer. ZigBee utilizes IEEE 802.15.4 standard at the lower PHY and MAC layer, which we have already discussed. The ZigBee network and security layer provides mechanism for network startup, configuration, routing and securing communication. So basically the ZigBee's network and security layer provides secure communication. It helps in network startup, configuring the network and routing. So it helps in calculating the routing path in what is often a changing topology, discovering neighbors and managing the routing. That is, the network and security layer in ZigBee helps in forming the topology and discovering the neighbors and help in managing the routing. We know that ZigBee network layer is responsible for forming the appropriate topology. Topology can be mesh topology or a star topology or a tree topology. ZigBee application support layer, which interfaces the lower portion of the stack, dealing with the networking of ZigBee devices with higher layer application. ZigBee predefines many application profiles for certain industry and vendors. That is, they support some custom application for certain industry and vendors. The custom application may be home automation or smart energy. These are the application example which uses ZigBee and ZigBee designed custom application for IoT. ZigBee utilizes 802.15.4 security at the MAC layer, which uses advanced encryption standard, that is AES, with 128-bit key. So ZigBee also uses AES as encryption technique. The key supported by AES is 128-bit. This also provides security at network and application layer also. ZigBee IP is also a protocol that is built upon IEEE 802.15.4. IP and TCP bar UDP protocol and various other open standard are supported at the network and transport layers currently. ZigBee specific layer are only found at the top of the protocol stack for the application. ZigBee IP was created to include open standard coming from the IETF work on LLNs such as IPv6, 6 LOWPAN and RPL. That is, it was created so that Zigbee can utilizes or can use the IPv6 or 6 LoWPAN and RPL standard, which are open standards. These open standards provide for low bandwidth, low power and cost effective communication when connecting smart objects. So, connecting smart object, there is a constraint of communication bandwidth. So, that is low bandwidth, low power and cost effective. ZigBee IP is used in Smart Energy SE Profile 2.0 specification. Smart Energy SE Profile 2.0 is a smart meter reading and residential energy management system which is built using ZigBee IP. Now let us look into the protocol stack of ZigBee IP. Basically, ZigBee IP is built upon IEEE 802.15.4 PHY and MAC layers. Then we can find 6 LoWPAN adaptation layer. Above that, IPv6, ICMPv6, 6 LoWPAN ND, RPL. Then we can find UDP and TCP layer, upon which you can find ZigBee IP, which is mostly utilized or used in Smart Energy Profile. We know that Smart Energy Profile is a profile which uses ZigBee for smart metering and residential energy management system. ZigBee IP supports 6 LoWPAN as an adaptation layer, as we seen in the ZigBee IP protocol stack. It utilizes the mesh over or route over method for forwarding the packets. It requires the support of 6 LoWPANs fragmentation and header compression schemes. That is, ZigBee IP support 6 LoWPAN fragmentation technique as well as header compression techniques. All nodes support IPv6, ICMPv6 and LoWPAN neighbor discovery and utilize RPL for routing of packet across the mesh network. So usually the topology supported by ZigBee IP is mesh. ZigBee IP devices can easily integrate and interoperate between any other 802.15 network easily, which are built on open IoT standard. So in this session we have learnt about access technology, IEEE 802.15.4 standardization and alliance, and also some protocol stack that uses IEEE 802.15.4 at MAC and physical layer. In the next session we'll look into the physical layer, MAC layer, topology and security provided by IEEE 802.15.4.